today. First things first, I kind of want to have this side of the garage a little more organized. And to make more space, I got to figure out what to do with the old ATV frame because I have no use for it anymore. But instead of just throwing it out, I kind of want to figure out something unique to do with it. And then later on today, the missus has copped some muscle car show tickets. So we're going to do that, but that's not what this video is going to be about. This video is going to be about the most frequently asked about topic on this channel, and that is regarding my ownership experience with my Genesis. And considering I have over 4 years of ownership and over 100,000 miles, I think I'm a little more credible than those brand snobs typing on their keyboards right now hating on the Hyundai brand. So I'm here to convince you, future Genesis owner, you will not regret purchasing this car. And to the brand snob haters, Hyundai made a great car, so just get over it. Also, trying to grow a beard, don't know how I feel about it. There's already gray in it. It kind of bumps me out. If you're new to the channel, I have a 2012 Genesis 5-liter R-Spec. I bought it just a little over 4 years ago with 29,000 miles. She is currently at 112,064 miles. So I have over 80,000 driven miles on this thing, and they haven't been babied to say the least. I bought it CPO, which means certified pre-owned. Basically means I get to continue the factory warranty of 10 years or 100,000 miles. The dealership also informed me at the time that that doesn't include bumper to bumper, which includes all the electronics being covered. So all I've had covered on this thing since I've owned it is drivetrain. I bought it for $27,500, and considering a few years before I bought this thing, they retailed at $47,000. So the depreciation on these things is absolutely insane. So we'll cut this video up into a few different parts. First of which, we'll cover maintenance costs, and then I'll cover everything that's held up over the years, everything that I love about this car after 4 years, and then we'll cover everything that's broken, everything that works intermittently, and things that I've grown to kind of not like about the Genesis over the years. Okay, maintenance. We'll start with oil changes. Everybody's gotta do oil changes. So I change mine every 5,000 miles with synthetic. If I go to the dealer, they'll charge me $77 every time. And if I do it on my own, which I do, it's about 40 bucks. I get my OEM filter on Amazon for about 11, 12 bucks, and then whatever oil that you choose. As for the infamous oil consumption issue, we'll touch base on that later in the video. I've also done a transmission flush at around 80K. It's recommended at 60K. I got that done at the dealership. They charged me 250 bucks. It's not really something you can do at home considering it's a sealed transmission. I've also done a differential change. That's recommended at 80. I did it at 80. That costs like 20, 30 bucks. Don't take it to the dealership. It's super simple to do on your own. Also, one of my rear turn signals started to go out. It's not that expensive, but it's worth mentioning. I've also done my spark plugs a couple videos ago. Those are recommended at 105,000 miles. I did mine just around 110,000. It's a very simple thing to do on your own. The only problem is those OEM spark plugs are not cheap. The cheapest I found them was on Rock Auto, and they were just a little over 15 bucks a piece. Also, Hyundai recommends putting in a bottle of their gas treatment in your tank. Apparently it's supposed to help with carbon buildup, but we get 93 out here, and that's all I've ever put in the car since I've owned it. And then the last thing was the battery, which actually lasted 6 years, so I've got my use out of that. And that cost me about $170 after core charge. As for brakes, you guys know I'm running the Brembos, but the research I've done, the OEM brakes do last quite a long time. One guy in the forums is running them past 100K. I don't know if that's legit or safe, but that's what he said. And if you're wondering, I've had my Brembos on for about 2.5 years. I know I just put that video up like last year, but I've had that footage for a while. It's actually getting time right now, 2.5 years to change the pads. They're getting low.
That's it.
It does not take a lot to maintain these cars, at least mechanically. I'm hardly ever at the dealership. The last time, like I said, was for that transmission flush, and that's only because it's sealed. I can't do it on my own. All the services I've done on my own, I've gotten OEM parts online, either on Amazon or Rock Auto, and they're in abundance. There's no shortage of OEM parts on Amazon, and they're affordable. What's coming up is a coolant flush and a serpentine belt, but I'm not there yet. Discs. By far, my biggest pet peeve of this car are the memory seats. It's like they have short-term memory loss or something. They just do not work. One setting is fine, but when I go to vacuum the car and I want to push the seat back manually and then hit the memory seat button again, it just reverts back to fully reclined, fully backed up. If you introduce a second setting, it just doesn't remember either one. So in my car, at least, the memory seats just do not work. The transmission, this is a true love-hate thing. It's a really good transmission for cruising. It's a very comfortable, smooth, consistent transmission. But as soon as you start driving sporty, it's hesitant, it's jerky. When you put it in manual mode and shift, it takes like a whole second and a half to actually engage the next gear. So the transmission is good and bad. Traction control. This is another love-hate thing. It's a really good traction control. It saved me a bunch of times in inclement weather. Very well tuned. But there are instances where you do want to turn it completely off. For whatever reason, you can use your imagination. And they did put a disable traction button in here, but it doesn't really disable it completely. It just kind of delays the traction like 1 or 2 seconds. I wish they put in a fully disable traction button in here, and there are ways to remedy that. And I will explain how to do that in a future video. The exhaust. So from the factory, this thing is just too quiet. They made both a 5-liter and a 5-liter R-Spec. I'd love to see them put a little more of an aggressive exhaust on the R-Spec, considering they did tune the steering to be more aggressive as well as the suspension. Weight. This thing is just too heavy. And that's expected for a fully loaded luxury sedan, but that's one drawback that I do not like. It's too heavy. Aftermarket support. And I've explained this in a previous video, but just to touch base on it, that's one thing I just do not like. It's a bummer, man, because these cars are awesome. It'd be nice to see some aftermarket parts get made for these things, but it is what it is. The rear seats do not fold. What the fuck? And last, the 2012 models did not come with Bluetooth for audio streaming. It only comes with Bluetooth calling. That kind of sucks. The way that you play music is through this stupid dongle thing. It's like a USB aux in one. Kind of sucks, but that's how you play music. I wish they did put audio streaming through Bluetooth in the 2012 models, but they learned from their mistakes and added it to the 2013 models. So those are the things that I hate. There are far more things that I love, starting with reliability. In my opinion, one of the most important traits in a luxury sedan should be reliability, and this thing is awesome. It's never left me stranded anywhere. It started every single time, apart from that one time that the battery died. If you're looking for a reliable, luxury, sporty sedan, this is the one. It's sleepy. This thing doesn't really look like anything. It's just a classic sedan that kind of flies under the radar, and I love that. Cops don't really turn their attention to them, and probably the best part of being sleepy, 16-year-olds don't want to race you at every stoplight in their Volkswagen, so that's nice. Value. Now, this is a big one. I mean, do I even have to say it? You get so much car for your money. I mean, this thing is fully loaded. You get a powerful V8, an 8-speed transmission, leather everywhere, heated back seats. I mean, if you were to spend that kind of money on a German counterpart, you'd be spending double, even triple that. So this car for the money, in my opinion, you can't get any better. Interior quality. Not a single place in the interior that I can look that's faded or cracked. All the plastic buttons are wearing quite well. The leather on the seats aren't ripped. They're not cracked. They're not faded. Everything looks like from the day that I bought it. Also, it doesn't creak. There's only one instance where I do get a creak, and that's when the cutouts are open open, the cigarette lighter actually rattles. But other than that, I can't find a single rattle. It's super quiet, even on the stiff coilovers that I ride in the summer. Awesome build quality. The motor, 6 years later, this thing still pulls hard. It's still consistent, it's still smooth. I'm getting the same gas mileage since the day I got it. I love this motor. Transmission. I know that I already talked shit about the transmission, but I've been doing some research online, and I guess a few people have transmission issues. I haven't had any. Some people were talking about theirs going out at 70K. But from my personal experience, my transmission has been fine, you know, other than the issues that I mentioned earlier. But it doesn't slip or anything like that, so it's still holding strong. The electronics. There's a few that don't work anymore, and I would say about 80% of them still work. So the heated cool seats still work beautifully. The infotainment and the speakers are still strong. They sound amazing still. The radar cruise control is still consistent, works reliably. The auto dim mirrors work like a clock. The sunshade still goes up and down quietly, reliably, consistently. There's a lot of people online that actually complain about their sunshades, about them rattling, and they actually have to put foam to prevent them from making noises, but mine's still been good. Okay, so before we carry on with the rest of the video, we're actually on the way to that muscle car show, so we're gonna go knock that out real quick, and then we'll touch base with the rest of this video, which includes everything that's broken, everything that works intermittently, and stuff like that. Should I just do a quick edit? Should I just add a quick edit?
Obviously, Elliot.
Okay, I'm gonna ask you an important question, okay?
Okay.
What's the edit song?
The one a beer song.
Which one?
The one that a beer song sings. You know which one I'm talking about.
No. Oh, Young and Rude?
Yes.
Okay. You've officially redeemed yourself.
Apartment. Another night I fell asleep in my shoes. It's getting old cause now I do it.
Man, what a show. I gotta start making more money. All right, so what's wrong with the Genesis? It can't possibly be perfect after 4 years of ownership, and it's not. So we'll start with the exterior. So the paint is like super delicate. It's not very durable. It paint chips super easy. And the lower part of the front bumper is just completely filled with rock chips. The clear coat is peeled. Doesn't look good. Had I known that, I probably would have expelled at least the front end of the car. Parking sensors. They seem to work whenever they want. More so not. The front and rear parking sensors do not work, which is fine. It's a big car. It'd be nice to have that. It's such an irritating thing to go wrong with this car because every time you're driving under 5 miles per hour, the dash lights up indicating that there's an issue, and it beeps. Really fucking annoying. Driver's door lock. So this tends to have the most issues when it's hot, especially when it's really humid. So when you unlock the car with the key fob, all the doors unlock except for the driver's door, which is the main one that should open. And that's really annoying because you have to undo the key from the key fob, insert it in the keyhole, unlock it, and then open the door manually like that. So in the heat, the driver's door lock is very intermittent. Rear view camera. So this just went out one day. I have no idea why. I believe it's the camera and not the module because the lines still show up, but the camera is just a black screen. Sunroof. So this is apparently a common issue. I'm gonna go ahead and take the fault on this because I've never serviced sunroof before. I've never greased the slides or anything. One day, went to go tilt it. It tilted open just fine, got to work, went to go close it, and this nasty, nasty grinding sound came from the sunroof. It wouldn't close, so it was tilted open. Called the dealer, they wanted way too fucking much. Apparently, there's a lot of labor involved. They quoted me a couple grand. I'm not gonna pay that. I hardly use the sunroof anyway, so what I did was just force down the sunroof with my hand, pulled the fuse, and that's just what it is. Leaky taillight. So this actually took me quite a while to figure out. Every time it would rain or snow would melt off the trunk, my taillights would do this. So I took a water bottle and spilled some on the trunk, found out that actually it was leaking into one of the taillights onto the brake light harness, and it would make the contacts on the harness wet, therefore shorting out the circuit, disabling all functionality of the rear brake lights. So as a quick fix, I took some electrical tape and taped the harness so that when water would be introduced, it would just roll off of it. I do plan on getting another taillight if the problem persists, but for now it's working. Oil consumption. Yes, my 2012 Genesis 5 liter does consume oil. Now hear me out. I was covered under warranty. I could have put in a claim. I could have done that whole thing, got approved, and got a new motor. However, Hyundai claims that 1 quart per 1,000 miles is normal consumption. I'd rather deal with topping it off with a little bit of oil, which, by the way, is not much. Between oil changes, I maybe put in half a quart, which is every 5,000 miles. But I'd much rather deal with that than some mechanic having a bad day and all the variables that come with a motor swap. So if you wanted to just bypass the oil consumption issue altogether, I suggest getting a 2013 or 2014 model. And that's it. That's everything that's gone wrong with the car in the past 4 years since I've owned it. None of which really bother me, aside from the rear view camera. It is a super helpful feature considering it is such a big, long car, but I was looking at the service manual. Doesn't seem too hard to attempt to fix it on your own, so I'll probably take a crack at that in the future. Just a quick search this morning, a 2013 with 12,000 miles on it, they wanted 20 grand. It's a brand new car practically. It'll last for years to come, and you're paying under 25 grand for it. You're not gonna get that kind of deal in the German market. Take it from me, from a guy that's owned this car for quite a number of years, has a shit ton of miles on it. Don't listen to those brand snobs. If you're on the cusp, if you're cross-shopping the Genesis, if you're even remotely thinking about pulling the trigger, I'm telling you, go drive one. They're awesome, reliable, powerful sedans. You're not gonna regret it. First video in 2019, we did an awesome year last year. We hit 500 subs in the last year, which is fucking, it blows me away. But it's like this on YouTube, but it's huge for me. So thank you guys. All right, I'm done trying to convince you. Get out there and drive one. It's probably gonna take me a couple times because you're in here.
Yeah, because you don't know what you're doing.
I don't. Are you recording?
No.
Okay, go ahead. Wait, stop. Are you recording?
No.
Don't waste my memory card.
I'm not.
Okay, go. Tell me what.
Now!
Okay.
Wait. Okay, now.
Yeah, you're making me laugh. Okay, ready? Stop, stop.
No.
Is this zoomed in now? Is that zoomed out?
Yeah.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
I can't.
Literally no one's laughing.
I know, but you're there. Okay, ready?